So, let's talk about how to make people listen. So you have your data, which we will talk about. We will keep it there. And I'm sharing some model, some metaphor with you, which will help you to figure out how we can relate to this particular model. What are you looking for? Your notepad?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Pen somewhere. Yeah, here it is. So we are done in case you want to take the coffee away. So I usually give this Masterji metaphors. So many of you have already heard it. You find a repeat of story. But anyway, I have to repeat it. So I can't tell. So many times in your life, you may have a person who is very good, who is great, who knows everything. But you run away from that guy. I call this guy as a master. So he's like coming from a very disciplined background. He has everything settled in his life and he wants everybody to be settled in their life. Maybe telling you to eat healthy food, maybe telling you to go home on time, not to work too much, anyway your life is only one and all those kind of stuff. And this is a real like a good guy. But you respect the guy. It's not like that you feel that he's a stupid guy, but you run away from him. I call this guy type of master. Can you relate to someone like this? Maybe distantly in your life or in your organization or in your family or in your friend circle. You say this is a gyani guy, yeah. Okay, let's stay away from them, he will eat my mind. And whenever he finds you, he catches you. Aja. So let me fix you. So if you become visible to him, he will catch you and try to fix you. Then there is an opposite person who is like as spoiled as you. He's like a cool guy. He's as spoiled as you. He doesn't know anything much. But whenever you get into trouble, you go to this guy. You ask questions to him, you want to take an advice. If you are sick, you go to him. Then there is a problem, children. You know something. And he doesn't know anything. But you usually go to this guy. Yeah?
Frequency
matches, yeah. So because he gives you a good listening. And you find him like you. So whatever happens, you do go to this guy. And he never forces you to do anything. He may give you some advice, and if you follow that advice, it's good. If you don't follow that advice, then also it's good. He's not bothered you are getting fixed or not. Masterji focuses on fixing you. If you don't follow his advice, he may give you a call. What happened? I told you that thing. Yeah, check the status. He asks that, okay, have you done that? So what are these two extreme metaphors are? This is a type of great guy, but we start running away from this guy. And there is a more or less like us. But we go near to that guy. And if we can create a mixture personality, we solve the problem. If we can become a personality which has elements coming from him, because we are not as lost as the cool guy, but people also feel as comfortable as going to this person, we can solve the problem of our agile coaching. If we can create this hybrid personality, people will listen to us and we will be able to help them to find better stuff for their own life, for the community, for the agile projects. So how do we create that in-between personality? So you have collected various data which is all relevant. We have a model which is called SCARF. So it is just a way to think of a middle personality which can help us in talking and taking people. And this is what we teach in our IC Agile coaching programs and all. That's why I was saying that for a few minutes I repeat. Now what is SCARF model? It says that there are few dimensions. If you take care of them, people will listen to you. If the Masterji starts following SCARF model, he can reach you. This guy, if he learns something like Masterji, and because he already follows SCARF, but he is not knowledgeable, then he reaches